Hello, everybody. My name is Christopher Hudson, and today what we're going to talk about are the corners in the golf swing. There's a lot of teachers online that think if you take a tee peg and you put it about 6 inches to the outside of the right of your right foot, and then 6 inches to the outside of your left foot, that those are the corners in the golf swing. And they talk about going to the first corner, and then when you get to the first corner, point the butt of the club at the tee peg, okay? Well, actually, there's actually more corners in the golf swing than just those two, but they talk about it. You make the first turn, and then when you're coming down, you're going to turn around that tee peg and hit the ball straight. Like I said, there's actually more corners than just the two that most people see in front of us. So we can understand the Polygon Golf Swing Trainer is set up that it's got a corner on here, two, three, and four. Four corners on the right, four corners on the left. So we've got the baseline, R1, R2, R3 in the top line, the baseline, L1, L2, L3 in the top line. So we can figure out, it's real simple. We don't have to use T-pegs and whatever. We need to see the visual in the totality of what it is in three-dimensional space. So when you're standing inside the Polygon Golf Swing Trainer, watch how easy it is. There's the first corner. So now all I'm gonna do is follow that corner with my hands, follow the R1 guide, and then corner into the second corner, corner into the third corner, and then I'm at the top. Now, if I had a driver in my hand, that shaft would be a little more flat back here, and I'd hit the fourth corner, and then when we come down, it's 4, 3, 2, 1, and as I'm going from the second corner to the first corner, my body's turning, and I'm releasing that club. And as you can see, the shaft is now matched up to the L3 pipe and the R1 guide so that it's a fully symmetrical swing. So when you can understand that there's actually four corners on the right, four corners on the left, and you truly have a good way to see them, then it's like, wow, this is a really easy game. It doesn't matter what method you're using. It doesn't matter if you bump to the right, get your weight on your right and pivot, and then bump to the left, use the ground forces and come up. That's one way to do it. Or you could use the stack and tilt method and just follow the corners in the golf swing along with the guides, and it's gonna be good. It doesn't matter if you shift the way that we shift here at Polygon Golf or the way that I do, and then come down and do it. The biggest thing is that golf instruction is extremely complicated. Some people make it that way. Some people try to simplify it. It's just confusing to the masses. But what if I told you there is a way to shoot in the 70s and maybe even below, depending on what happens during your round. But starting off with understanding the geometry and the patterns that surround the body are the quickest way to get you into the 70s. You have to remember, Ben Hogan said, if you just understand a couple of different things, shooting over 80 is a difficult thing to do. Well, you know, a lot of people can be like, well, that's kind of a bold statement. It's Ben Hogan, one of the best golfers ever to play the game. But he wasn't lying, guys. He's telling you the truth. When you can understand that there truly is this pattern that surrounds the body in three-dimensional space, it's really difficult not to hit the ball well. You're going to hit it further. You're going to hit it straighter. But when you can understand there's actually four corners on the right and four corners on the left. See, a lot of people think that the golf swing is a circle. So they're like, how can there be corners in a circle? But it's the geometry that if we follow it, is going to allow this club head to move in a perfect circle around the tilted spine. So if we can just understand how to make these angle changes at the four corners in the golf swing, then all of a sudden your ball striking and your power and your accuracy is going to improve. So remember, there's four corners. The first corner is on the right. We get to that corner. We set the hands. We're working up the R1 guide. We've gone into the second corner. We're working up the R2 guide. We get into the third corner. Now the shaft is working up the L3 guide. Then we're at the top. Then when we're coming down, we're going to move down the guide, get into the third corner, get into the second corner. Now right here, my entire body is opening up and releasing this club as it makes an angle change on that first corner, but it's that snapping move right there where the body's opening up and doing all this stuff. Now, we're not talking about that. We're talking about the corners. But when you understand these corners correctly, your body is going to respond. So again, the four corners on the right-handed player, four corners on the left, left-handed player, four corners on the left, four corners on the right. Simple. Simple. I can just make this pattern all day long, and you're going to see it's the simplest thing to do. So if you have any questions, fill out the comments. My name is Christopher Hudson. Check us out at polygongolf.com. Take care.